Hi everyone, welcome back to my channel. My name is Hayes. I'm an artist's speed painter from Malaysia, and today we're going to take a look at Stable Diffusion. So Stable Diffusion is one of the most popular app right now for generating AI artwork. There are several AI predecessors before Stable Diffusion like Midjourney, Disco Diffusion and DALL-E 2. But Stable Diffusion was highly anticipated because it was such a good result coming out of it, and then all the portraits are so beautiful. So today we're going to jump right into exploring Stable Diffusion for a first look. So Stable Diffusion actually started in their Discord channel. The beta was running already and we were given channels to prompt using !dream. And then with every prompt, we had to wait for 1 minute before we can prompt again. Even though we made typos or mistakes in our prompt, we still got to wait again for 1 minute before we can do another prompt. So right now, Stable Diffusion already launched their web app beta, which is located at beta.dreamstudio.ai, and you can actually just go in there and sign up and purchase some credits and you are good to go. But I heard that right now they are actually giving away free credits for people to try out this app, so maybe you can just go in there and try your luck and see if you have any credits allocated for you to test out their amazing AI tool. So because it is new, it does has a lot of bugs, so we're gonna go through all of them. So when it comes to generating prompts, we usually decide what artist is influenced by saying by this artist, that artist, or in the style of artist A, B, C, or painted by, or art by artist 1, 2, 3. So these are all various formats of prompts that can actually give you very different results in Stable Diffusion. In Stable Diffusion, the prompts are really sensitive, so whatever you do with your keywords and how you order them, like for example how you order your artist, it puts a lot of weight into the generated art itself. So after you have generated any images, you can just copy the seed number by hovering over the image and clicking on the seed number itself. Then you can input this seed number into the field right here to generate the exact same image and tune from there. So when you input your seed number into the field and it's only working on one seed number, you can actually just keep tweaking the prompt and it will just keep generating the same image while changing a little bit of details according to how your prompt is arranged. But bear in mind that the larger your images are, there will be a significant drop in speed when it comes to generating your prompt, and also you can see that the credits are racking up really, really fast. So here I'm going to test out if it listens to no, because it's trying to put in figures and females every time I use certain artists like I think Ilya and Alphonse Mucha. So if I use their artist names in the prompt, it kind of just keep dropping figures of females into the generated art itself, and I'm trying to see if they will listen to no human, no female, no girl, but it doesn't seem to work. They kept pimping out girls non-stop. So the first bug that you should be aware of in Stable Diffusion is that it tends to crash. So when it crashes, you have to refresh it, and when you refresh it, the history are not kept, because the histories are actually kept in the cache, and every time you reload it, it goes away. So they do not have like a storage area where they save all your files, all your generated prompts. Nope, they do not have that. So you can't access your history. But what you can do is download as you go. So if you do not download as you go, you will lose your images. I can guarantee you that. And not only that, you can't even get back your old prompt to make more dreams generation. So make sure that you download often and also copy to keep your successful prompt once you have one ready. And another thing that I figured out is once you created a new tab, the Dream Studio doesn't work on the new one. It's kind of clunky, but I think working in one tab is still quite okay because it's quite fast. And also if you generate on the default scale like 512 by 512, your credit expenditure will be kept low and you will be able to generate a lot of images from there. But bear in mind that the moment you change the aspect ratio of your generated output, the entire prompt will change, which means the visual will not be the same anymore. You will not be able to get the same art in a taller format. So here I'm so frustrated that the figures are still appearing, so I'm trying a new keyword called still life to see if the figures still appear. So it does not listen to me. So right now in the CFG scale, I'm increasing it from 7 to about 10 or 13. So if you increase the CFG scale, it will start to listen to you. So here's a few tips for generating concepts. Work on typing a prompt of emotions and symbolism instead of literal subject matter. So just don't order things like apple, oranges, and a cat on a wall, but do something like symphony of poverty, the misery of the Great Wall. So this will actually generate images that you cannot imagine. And if you try to generate portraits, you can see that the likeness is amazing. So right here, I have generated Keanu Reeves. And if I put them side by side, young and old, you can see it's starting to mess things up. But if I try Anthony Hopkins, it seems to work well. And you can actually just hold the seat stable and try and adjust the prompt from here. So right now I am trying to turn him into an android. So when it comes to turning humans into android, robot and android does not work as well as biomechanical keywords. So use the word biomechanical and you will get fantastic results. So from here we can infer the hypothesis that with multiple subject matter that has different properties, they will actually assign the properties randomly. So right here I have a couple of animals and a human, but because there is a tiger in the prompt, they are randomly assigning the tiger stripes to any of the subject matter in the generated artwork. So to solve this, it's really easy. Just remove the item with the odd property and it will be fine. So right now, let's try to generate an artwork from an image. So usually to generate an artwork from an image, we usually upload an image or paste an image link into the prompt space. So here I'm pasting the Starry Starry Night into the prompt space and we can see that it's actually working out. It's turning out to be a Starry Starry Night by Monet, but it wasn't actually reading the image itself. It was actually reading the keyword Starry Starry Night inside the link itself, because when I pasted another link by Sargent and there is the word lily in the link, the generator outputs kept churning out flowers instead of the portrait. So a turnaround for this is if the artwork is famous enough, you can just reference the artwork directly and change the style by assigning another artist. So one disclaimer about plagiarism and artists, so Stable Diffusion is very powerful. It can get quite close to the original artist, but it's not the same because it still have their own style. It's just like a student trying to learn from different masters. So when it comes to assigning artist names, it's not really plagiarism, because sometimes when you're generating artwork, you're just trying to push it towards a genre. Let's say I want a genre that has a lot of line work, that has a lot of flat illustrations, so I will go for certain artists then. But if I want watercolor or with strokes that are wet or oily, then I will go for more traditional artist names. So these are ways you can push your artwork to go to a style that is probably uniquely yours. Maybe you already have your own style and you can actually cheat away to find a way for Stable Diffusion to generate artwork based on your style by a collection of artist names. Okay, so right now, as of this moment, Stable Diffusion can only generate artwork, but it does not have the ability to upscale your images. So most of your images will turn out 512 pixels wide or high, because the moment you enlarge the image, the prompt change and everything becomes very small. So the size of the face and the flowers are still the same. It's just the image got bigger and there's a lot more details in there. So a way to get around this is to generate it in the small size to get the prompt that is beautiful, and after that you can upscale it. So for upscaling, I would suggest that you use this app called Gigapixel AI by Topaz Labs. So all you have to do is to install this app and then drag it into the scene. Then after that, you can either scale it by multiplication ratio, 2x, 4x, or 8x, or you can also input in your width and height manually. So here we are inputting it manually. And usually I would just use standard and I would turn off auto, remove all the blur and noise input. Then we will also turn off face recovery, because that tends to blur the face. Like when you upscale from a low resolution to a high resolution old photo, they want to keep it blur so that the face is still recognizable as that same person. So after the upscale, this is the before after. So this is from 512 pixels and I upscale it to about 4K height, and I can do it multiple times across different apps after that to get it double in size if I want a final output. Okay guys, thank you so much for watching today's video. It is an amazing app, so if you are interested in trying it out, please try out beta.dreamstudio.ai. I am actually sponsored for credits in this video, but I will actually be paying for my membership once the credits run out. So I hope you enjoyed today's video, and I'll see you next time. Remember to comment, like, and subscribe. Bye!